Hello and welcome everyone. Today we are here in a quick discussion with one and only Adil Jal Darukhanwala, a man who doesn't need any introduction in the space of automobiles and motorcycles, of course. My mentor and my ex-boss, and I'm very happy to be here with him. And today we're going to discuss about a few things about his book on the Java motorcycles, the history of Java and the rebirth of the brand in India and the world now. So, Adil, we would...
You said too many things about
yeah. Well, there's still far too less what I could say.
Okay, let's not do that. Let's get on to what you have gathered here for.
Yeah, so most of us have read your book about the Java, the Forever Bike. And of course, it's like those pages are filled with so much of history and information, so many... details and trivia, that it's just you keep reading and you still have to go through it again and again to revise. Coming to the very, very fundamental question, how did the idea of the book happen? Who came up with it?
It happened very naturally because the son of one of the original founders of Ideal Java is also very much associated with the rebirth of the new brand. So he's also invested in Classic Legends, and Burman Irani and me go back to the 1980s.
Right.
And when he was trying to keep Ideal Java afloat, right, in those terrible years when the Indo-Japs came in,
yeah,
and Ideal Java didn't have any sort of technological help from its Czech counterpart,
right,
because they also were in a bad mess with the Iron Curtain disintegrating, yeah, and whatnot. So it was a double whammy for them, and I knew how much of a live wire Burman was at that time and what all he did. But he was fighting a battle with one hand tied behind his back, one hand also anchored somewhere else. So it was tough. So I knew him from that time, and we had worked with him together. So one day when I got a call out of the blue, I think it was in 2017, November or December, he says, Adil,
exactly 20 years after the 96, the brand shut down, right?
Yeah, 96. It shut down, and the facets were auctioned off in 2002, 2003.
Yeah.
So, 2017, November or December, I got the call from Burman, and I said, Burman, where have you come from? He says, I'm always there. Burman, as not many more you will be aware, is also the genius behind this real estate firm in Bombay, Rustamji.
Yes.
He runs that. He has been exceptional in that field.
Right.
So he said, Adil, come and meet me because I want something. He says, whatever. He says, you heard the name Java? I said, yes, I think so. Thanks to you. He says, but I want to talk to you about it. So I landed up there. And first thing he said was, after he hugged me and all that, Adil, I've got little time and only little time to talk to. I wanted to write a book on Java.
Oh, wow.
I said, what about? He says, I don't care. I've seen your Mercedes-Benz book. I've seen your other books. I want you to do a book on the history of Java. Nothing more was said. Nothing was discussed. Oh. He left it to me. He says, Adil, just go and do it. And 10 minutes later, Anupam Thareja walks in.
Okay.
And he says, ask Burman, Baba ke saath ho gaya?
Oh.
So this is the sort of thing which came across. I don't think that there are any people who can, what you call, repose so much faith in someone like me to do that thing. Means I was humbled. I was very happy as well that they asked me to.
But you didn't have an idea like back then that they're bringing the brand.
No, I did not know Burman was involved with Classic Legends. I knew Classic Legends was happening.
Right.
But I never knew. At that time, then I came to know about it.
Okay.
And that narration is also there in the book.
Yeah, right.
As to how Burman was involved in this.
Right. So this Anupam's meeting with Burman happened before this.
Yes, yes. Absolutely.
Very head instead of...
That also I must narrate. when Classic Legends got the rights to make bikes using the Java name for India, Southeast Asia, and some other markets.
Right.
So Anand Mahindra, through the Mahindra Investment Group, who's 60% owner of Classic Legends, asked Anupam to go and meet Burman because he is the still the repository the Ideal Java name, legacy, etc.
Ideally, it was his sister they thought was, but she told him that like, Burman is looking after all.
Yeah. Because Anand Mahindra knew his sister.
Right.
Who, because they are both in
studied together.
Right. So in Uti, so from there they found out meet Burman. So Anupam was sent by Anand, called Burman, said, I want you to meet someone.
Right.
So he says, okay, Burman gave him a time. Burman was expecting someone who will be a big suit, come and tie and jacket and whatnot. And he says, yeah, meet me at so-and-so time at my office. And there comes
Anupam,
a hobo, kurta, beads, ponytail, completely spaced out guy. And Burman is waiting for someone suited, booted, and this guy is sitting there.
Least expected.
And then they came. So he says, yeah, what can I do for you? He says, see here, we are going to do Classic Legends, we are going to do Java. Before he could say that, Anupam thought that he'd offer a price to Burman to let go of any legal rights or anything.
And the Java brand.
The Java brand, JSD brand, whatever, let it repose with Classic Legends. And he also had a figure in mind what he could, what you call, pay
offer,
that thing.
Yeah, offer Burman.
But before he could say that, Burman said, hold it. I want to, what you call, invest in this.
Yeah.
My dad, unfulfilled legacy that it should carry on.
Yeah.
This is a chance. And it was a completely different aspect. And that's how these guys got together.
It's also
very important that Anand Mahindra said, yes. Bring that, because that gives the bloodline to
the whole effort.
The whole effort. So there is a linkage. It's great that Anupam, who has done so much great, he was one of the architects, in fact, of the resurgence of Royal Enfield.
Absolutely.
Not many people know about it, but you have to give him credit. And he was instrumental in that. So it was great on both Anupam's part and Anand's part that they saw the logic. And today these three guys, have really done something great in that sort of sense.
Absolutely. I mean, it's such a wonder that the whole gene pool of Java comes back into this game.
Absolutely.
And somebody gone to offer and buy out, gets an investor in
game. I'll narrate one more incident. When this whole deal was being formed, even though Java in the Czech Republic had in principle agreed and the MOU was being signed, but they were still not, they were hesitant, they thought that what will these Indians do across over there, what sort of bike they will make.
And they already had a tie-up with some Chinese manufacturer also.
That Java in the Czech Republic has that thing. They make about 1,000 bikes a year.
Correct.
So when the one meeting, then Anupam took Burman with him. So that old man who was there, the Geosplos Industries, which owns the Java brand there.
Right.
So they were sitting in the Java conference, main conference hall.
Right.
And he was speaking, even though this guy knew English, he was speaking through an interpreter.
Yeah, they had an interpreter there.
So Burman got a little, bored with all the discussions going on. So he started wandering around the conference hall and suddenly saw a picture where his father, his uncle, and the original Java guy. And he said, hey, that's my dad's photograph.
Wow.
So the old man says, ask, what is it? So then the interpreter says, that moment he says, okay, I want to do the deal with them.
Oh.
So I think it brings so many different things into the picture, into the mix. And I think that Java in India is a brand with ample stories, great legacy, down to earth stuff, simplicity, And I think everything shows up.
The star lined up for this project. Almost. Yes. Just fell in place.
Just as the stars were conspired against Ideal Java in the 80s with the advent of the Indo-Japs.
Right. Right.
25 years, 30 years later, you suddenly find a role reversal.
Wow. Wow. That's such an interesting piece. Who would have thought?